High. What a great group. They've been entertaining us all morning long, and hopefully we'll get one more song out of them before they have to go. Thanks so much for joining us again. You know, did you spend hours in school, at home, perhaps highlighting your textbooks? Did you do that? I know I was that guy. Well, you may have been wasting your time. A new study out of Kent State says highlighting doesn't actually help you learn. Professor John Dunlowski is a psychology professor at Kent. He's here to show us why flashcards are a much better option. Professor Dunlowski, you know, you've got a book here, a typical textbook, sure. And I'm just as guilty as the next guy. And I never really thought highlighting helped me learn better, but it helped me really highlight the things that I needed to know.
Right. First, I would never take a highlighter away from a student. We all use these things. I used it still. Difficulty is often when you look at what students are doing with their highlighting, they almost mark everything in the text. Nothing is that important.
Okay? This would be my textbook when I was back in university, which was
many right. That's years not going to help too much
yeah,
at all.
Yeah, it's just completely highlighted all over the place. But you right. say no. That's not the way we do it.
No, I think the better student is actually going to just mark those aspects of the text that they think are most important. Unfortunately, just highlighting isn't enough. I mean, this is kind of a beginning to a learning journey and not the end of it. In this case, there are other things they have to do to supplement the highlighting, to basically learn the materials.
Yeah, you say flashcards.
Flashcards are great. Many students use these. I don't think they always use them right, though. So what I would do, I would first go through the textbook and use your highlighter.
Sure.
Your favorite color, the one that's scented or something like that, and highlight all the important information.
Okay.
Then go back and make your flashcards where you put right here, key term definitions, some important concept on the front.
Okay.
Right, and the correct definition on the back.
Okay, very good.
So then, maybe a couple days later after you've read the textbook, you come back to these and you test your memory. You try to retrieve the information from your memory. So you look at phenotype, you try to recall the correct answer, and then you look at the back of the card. Okay.
This is an intensive study. This is.
It turns out it's a little bit more effortful than just reading. The difficulty is when students go back and just reread the important notes, they do so passively. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're all guilty of this. You'll be tired, maybe studying a topic that you're not that interested in, and your mind starts to wander. What retrieving information from memory does is really push you to actively process the information. It's a really effective technique.
So that would take time then, because I was a professional procrastinator.
Of course.
I would cram the night before for a couple of hours and I would retain the information, but ask me after the test 3 weeks later, I couldn't remember
anything. You know, if the teacher's going to give you a cumulative exam at the end where they're going to basically test you on everything you've learned, which is a really good teaching practice, yeah, you're not going to do so well in that cumulative exam. The key really, instead of just using a cramming session. Almost all students cram, right? It kind of reduces your anxiety level the night before a test. What you should instead do is use these cards several weeks in advance with just smaller, shorter study sessions that are basically displaced in time. This kind of distributed practice with retrieval is a very effective way to really learn this information well. One thing we've noticed with our students who are using this technique, after you use these cards a couple times, it's very, very fast.
Yeah.
All the information comes to mind, and then it's right there when you need it at a test or when you need it in a subsequent class or something. So I really highly recommend flashcards.
Highly recommend flashcards.
Yeah.
Also, just reading here, you say have conversations with yourself
yeah.
about the material. Give yourself your own lecture.
Okay. Well, you know, when you're reading, say, a textbook, what you can do is instead of just highlighting the important information, each time you get to an important concept, you should ask your things like, how does this relate to other information I've already read in the textbook?
Yeah.
Or maybe you explain the content to yourself. And it turns out just engaging in these more active kinds of processing, like self-explanation, and basically just trying to describe how it relates to what you know, are another ways to actively process that really helps students' comprehension of the material.
Professor John Dunlowski from Kent State University, where were you when I need you 20 years ago? These guys are out of here. We need to get the flashcards. Thanks so much for joining us
today.
We really appreciate it.